Hello everyone, welcome to this channel Zoology Pyo. In this video I am talking about the perception. This is the very important topic in sense organ. So let's start. Perception. To survive, an organism must react to danger and take advantage of opportunity. Appropriate responses require information about the external environment, the body's internal physiology and previous experience. The results of previous experience are recorded within the nervous system as memory, but sensory receptors monitor the external and internal environments. Sensory receptors are specialized organs that respond to selected information. Sensory receptors code or translate environmental energies into nerve impulses that are transmitted to the central nervous system, or CNS, via afferent fibers. These impulses may or may not be received at conscious levels of the brain. Now let's go to the definition of perception. Perception is defined as processes of one's ultimate experience of the world and involves further processing of sensory input. Sensation and perception are virtually impossible to separate, because they are part of one continuous process. Perception in human processes sensory stimulation and translated into organized experience. The world is full of stimuli that can attract our attention through various senses. Thus, we are able to describe systematically the sights, sound, smell and taste that populate our conscious experience. It is a fundamental process in all interpersonal communication encounters. Stimulation, organization, interpretation, evaluation, memory and recall. These five stages of how we perceive people and the processes that influence our perceptions. In Gestalt's theory, he believed that complex is very important in perception. As we perceive events, the brain actively selects, organizes, and integrates sensory information to construct an event. Perception creates phases, melodies, and illusion of raw material of sensation. And now let's go to the five stages of perception. The first one is stimulation. The occurrence of sensory stimulation. Basically, this part of perception process involves in contact with a particular stimulus. The world is full of stimuli that can attract our attention through various senses. Thus, we are able to describe systematically the sight, sound, smell and taste that populate our conscious experience. Stimulation includes selective attention and selective exposure. Selective attention occurs by anticipating fulfilled needs and prove enjoyable. For example, friends talking to you, but you are daydreaming. You won't hear what they are saying until they called you your name. Selective exposure occurs by exposing information that will confirm an existing beliefs, contributing to objectives, and having a state of satisfaction. As we are not able to perceive everything that is happening around us simultaneously, we tend to engage in selective passive perception, perceiving only positive things. For example, after buying a laptop, one tends to read more online or ask people around that the product once bought is good, because we want to tell ourselves that we make the right decision and avoid negative feedback. And now the second stages of perception is organization. Organization, the capacity to identify and recognize objects and events is crucial for normal perception. Without that capacity, people cannot effectively use their senses. Perception which organized by rules, schemata and scripts. Organized by rules, people perceive things that are physically close together, constitute a unit. People developed schemata from actual experiences as well as vicarious experience from daily activities or from television. reading or RC. Some familiarity represented in mind will be some kind of schema. This would help one's perception to categorize into number of categories. However, it may cause perception error as it influences one's to perceive non-existent things or miss seeing things in presence. A script is a form of schema that focuses on action, event or procedure. It is a process of how we behaved and how we organized it with our own action, which organized by pattern. And now the third stage is interpretation evaluation. In this interpretation evaluation stages, it is two processes of stimuli by individual experiences, needs, wants, values, expectations, physical and mental emotional state, gender and beliefs, meaning based on by individual's rules, schemata and scripts. For example, meeting a new person who is a doctor, one tends to view this person as someone serious, successful, health conscious, academic strong. In other words, evaluating individuals depending on one's own scripts, the way individual behave and perform the action appropriate and inappropriate. And now the fourth one is memory. After undergoing the stage of stimulation, organization, and interpretation evaluation, this leads us to another stage called memory. It is a storage of both perception and interpretation evaluation that are kept according to scripts and schemes, events or experiences is not the objective of recollection but is more likely heavily influenced by individuals' preconceptions and individuals' schemata. And now the fifth one is recall. After some time, the memory that are stored individual want to recall certain information. Recall stage reconstruct what individual heard in a way that are meaningful. Recall information that consistent with schemes. However, failure to do so, it is inconsistent with schemas. Recall information drastically contradicts one's schema because it forces individual to think or even think. In a simple word, sensation that we as humans become conscious of are referred to as perception. Our view of the world is partially determined by the kinds of information our sensory receptors detect and by how that information is processed. Vertebrates differ in their ability to perceive stimuli. Bats and even dogs hear sounds at frequencies beyond our ears. Hawks can hunt high above the ground and detect tiny rodents scampering below. Rattlesnakes hunt in light too dim for humans to see in. Yet humans see the world in color, while the most other mammals see it only in black and white. Our perception of the world is limited or enhanced by the availability and sensitivity of our sensory receptors. It should also be emphasized that conscious sensations are an organism's subjective interpretation of environment. The environment contains chemicals and photons of light, but the sense of taste and color are interpretations of this phenomena. Similarly, pain does not exist in the environment. You cannot measure pain as you can measure temperature or forces or solar radiation. Taste, color, and pain are perceptions arising out of events in the brain itself. Nerve impulses carried by sensory nerves are electrical impulses. The optic nerve carries the same kind of electrical impulses as the auditory nerves, olfactory nerves, taste nerves, and so on. Different sensations result from different ways in which the nervous system interprets signals from different sensory receptors. Because the impulses are the same, the central nervous system can be fooled. Artificial stimulation of the auditory nerve is perceived as a sound. Artificial stimulation of the optic nerve is perceived as light. Mechanical pressure on the eyeball stimulates the optic nerve to send electrical impulses to the brain. These impulses are interpreted as what they are expected to be. Sensations of light rather than a mechanical stimuli. This is why a mechanical blow to the eye can make one see stars. To be clear, in discussing perception, we should distinguish an environmental stimulus from the way in which it is interpreted. But this is seldom done. In common usage and even in scientific research, convention rules, we speak the senses of seeing, hearing, tasting, smelling, and so on, as if the stimulus and the perception of the stimulus were the same. The treatment of sensory receptors in this video attempts to separate the kind of environmental energy or stimulus monitored from the nervous system's interpretation of that stimulus. So that's all about the perception, and that's all for today. If you like this video, hit the like button and please share this video as much as possible. And to get more videos related to this topic, don't forget to subscribe this channel. Thanks for watching this video.